Rock and roll came into my life when I was about 12, 13. Little Richard and Chuck Berry had just started hitting the shores of England. My brother had a skiffle band, as they called them back then.
I don't know what a skiffle band is.
Well, it was when people couldn't afford instruments after the war, and they started. He had a washboard and a T-chest upright bass and just a few acoustic guitars. I had a very high voice, and then suddenly my voice overnight did what voices do and found a new level.
Didn't take nothing that I didn't need, 'cause they didn't offer classes in what I want to be. They didn't offer manhood responsibility. Have to learn it the hard way, earn my degree in the streets. Graduated from Hard Knocks, I got my education.
I think it's fair to say that you are one of the greatest interpreters of songs. What is the key to making a song your own?
Well, sometimes it works, and you know, I've done other times I've tried doing songs that I didn't really think happened. I did a version of White as Shade of Pale one time that when you listen to it, you probably say, well, that's Joe Cocker singing a Procol Harum song. But like when you hear me doing Little Help from My Friends, you know it's a whole different thing completely. When I did Unchain My Heart, the Ray Charles, we completely changed the rhythm and it made it like a new song.
Unchain My Heart.
I wonder, when you're by yourself, when you're alone, is there a particular song that you have sung at some point in your career that comes to you, that you end up singing to yourself?
You Are So Beautiful, I think, is probably the strongest tune I ever did in just the simplicity of it. It was originally a gospel song, and Billy Preston rewrote the lyrics that made it a bit, I don't know what he was thinking of, make it more of a love song. But originally it was a song to Jesus. There's a little thing at the end goes, to me, you know, the note.
I know it, yeah.
Which when I sang it in the studio, I remember everyone pricking up their ears. You know, it kind of woke up something in me, that softer side that I had going for me. It comes into my mind a lot, that tune.
You are so beautiful.
That was Rachel Martin's interview with Joe Cocker. You can hear their entire conversation from 2012 at NPR.org.
Can't you see? Everything I hope for.
This is NPR News.